What's up, guys? So today we're going to be looking at the error code 19 on the Yamaha FZ6. This is a 2007 Yamaha FZ6 S2. And so we're going to be diagnosing the code 19 that it threw a couple weeks ago, and looking at the diagnostic mode and how to enter that, how to diagnose what the bike is reading, that kind of stuff. So a little bit of backstory. What happened was I was riding. I was just going 50 miles an hour just on a freeway. And then for about 1 second, bike was dead. No throttle response, just died. About a second later, came right back, bike rode fine. So next morning, I go out to start the bike, turn the key, press the start button, didn't start, like nothing. And then I checked again, turned the key off, turned the key on again, and where the time was supposed to be displayed, it said 19. I had no clue what that was. I had no clue where to start, how to diagnose it. So I did some digging, I did some Injaing around, and I found out what this was and how to fix it. So let's dive right into it. We need to enter diagnostic mode. So come on over here and we'll take a look. So if you're anything like me and your FZ6 or FZ1 throws a code, you're thinking, crap, my bike is finally falling apart. Like, it's that stage of the bike where it's just coming apart. But I can assure you, this is actually a pretty easy fix for code 19. And really for any other code in general. Typically, Yamaha FZ6s and FZ1s are very, very reliable bikes. So really they shouldn't explode until, you know, 80,000, 100,000 miles, then they'll start leaking some oil and that kind of stuff. But these kind of things are not that big of a deal, and usually very minuscule and minimal repair. So what you're gonna do to enter diagnostic mode is hold down the reset and select buttons at the same time. And then you're gonna put the key in, turn it to the on position. And you're still holding down these, hold them down for 5 seconds after it turns on, and it'll go into diagnostic mode. So it says DI, it's diagnostic mode. It's not D1, it's DI. So then when it says this, all you're gonna do is push these and hold these down for another second or two, and then it goes into diagnostic mode. And so right here you can see a 16, and this is diagnostic one. This is throttle response. So 16 means it's 16% throttle right now. And if I turn the throttle, as you can see, I'm turning the throttle all the way to 100. And it should be 16 to 17 for closed throttle. So you let it go back and it's at 16. But if it is at 17%, that's not a big deal. That's normal. So 16 to 18-ish percent is normal. So anyway, that's diagnostic mode. And you push select to go through the different ones. I'm not exactly sure what all of them are, just off the top of my head. The owner's manual does have all of the codes in it, and I'll actually pop it up on the screen for you right now. So these are all the diagnostic codes here. And so going through them, I think diagnostic 5 off the top of my head is the ambient air temperature. And then I'm pretty sure diagnostic 6 is the coolant temperature. And then you can go through and there's a lot of different ones. So code 19, as I remember correctly, it was 21, and that is the kickstand switch. That's what the code was throwing when it gave me the code 19. It was reading an error, an open circuit with something related to the starter switch. And what that ended up being for me was the kickstand switch. The connector of the kickstand was getting a little bit old. It had just, you know how it is, connections go bad over time. So what it ended up being was the connection just needed to be taken out, cleaned, and then reconnected because one of the wires wasn't connecting correctly. And so my bike thought that the kickstand switch was on and that it needed to keep the bike off. The FZ6 and pretty much every sport bike and modern bike, the sidestand switch basically keeps the bike from running if the kickstand's down. And so that's what it was doing. So the code 19 actually ended up being a sidestand switch malfunction in my case. And to test that, it's the diagnostic 21. So basically this is the sidestand switch. If you move the sidestand up and down, it should go off and on and off and on. And so the problem with this was, and this is a very, very common issue for these bikes, Yamaha apparently has this issue in a lot of different sport bikes, is the side stand switch actually malfunctioning. The connection just gets old over time. In my case, my side stand switch works fine. It was just the connection. So I disconnected it, cleaned it out a little bit, and reconnected it, and the code 19 went away. So it was a stupid easy fix, but I had no clue where to start right when it happened. and it gave me the code. So the kickstand's down and the side stand switch, for example, if I put it in neutral, you can see it's reading it correctly because it says off and on. So if you put it in first, it goes back off. And so that means the bike is not going to turn on if it's in first gear. All right, so there you have it. That is the diagnostic mode on my Yamaha FZ6. Again, this is an 07 FZ6 S2 model. This also works for any of these gauge clusters here for the FZ1 as well. So I hope this helped you out. When I got the code, I had no clue what to do. And really it was just a lot of people on the forums kind of bickering and kind of thinking, well, it could be this too, it could be that, blah, blah, blah. Nobody knows how to enter diagnostic mode. So here it is. If you guys need help, this will do it for you. So you should be able to troubleshoot, especially looking at the codes and the diagnostics for the codes in the owner's manual. You can pretty much troubleshoot any electrical failure in the bike just by doing that. So you don't, there's no guesswork. This was basically code. It could be a side stand switch or a failure in the starter switch. But since it wasn't, it was a side stand switch. It's pretty simple. So yeah, all I had to do was to fix this code, in my case, was unbolt the tank, take those two plastics off, lift the tank. I had my wife hold the tank up while I did it. But the side stand switch connects right underneath the tank. It's a little blue connector, two wire connector. Just kind of follow it from the side stand. There's just a wire. Just follow it, unplug it, clean it, plug it back in, and that's all it needed in my case. So it was pretty simple. All right, guys, I hope this helped you out. If it did, absolutely subscribe. I'd love to have you, and I'm hoping that these videos keep helping you out in the future as well. So yeah, I think that's it. Make sure to like the video if you haven't, because it helps us out here on YouTube. You guys are beasts. You guys are bosses. I'll see you next time.